It's getting harder and harder to remain objective here, but I will gallantly try. Trevor Jacob claims he had an engine failure and his only safe option was to bail out with his parachute. The plot just keeps getting thicker and thicker. This is a great example of how a community bands together to solve a problem. Really sharp eyes noticed that he clearly had a tank strapped to his calves. If you look carefully, you can see the outline of the pressure gauge in this view, and you can see the outline of the cylinder in many views. Because of the pressure gauge, it's probably a fire extinguisher. So what kind of fire extinguisher? This is my aircraft, and this is the fire extinguisher I carry. It's specific for aircraft, it's halon, and you'll notice it's very, very small. If you compare the size of this to the size of the one that Trevor apparently has strapped to his leg, mine seems quite a bit smaller. My guess is that what he has is a residential fire extinguisher, not an aviation halon fire extinguisher. So why on earth did he have these tanks strapped to his calves? We're going to examine his possible motives and what might have been in those tanks. Remember, a fire extinguisher is just a tank that contains a pressurized liquid. It's very easy to put anything in those tanks. It could have been fire retardant, it could have been gasoline, it could have been water. So let's start by what we know. One, it's got a pressure gauge and it looks a lot like a fire extinguisher. Number two, he did not want us to see it. That's important. And number three, even though we planned on going back to the plane to get the GoPros, he wanted these tanks with his person and he did not want to leave them in the aircraft. That's going to be an important clue in figuring out what his plan was. This is a good time to point out, this video is simply my opinion and my conjecture on what happened. This is not facts. This is not police work. This is my opinion. Okay, so what do I think his motive was? Pretty clear. Fame and fortune, and he didn't want to get caught. So we wanted to be famous, make lots of money, and not end up in jail. Pretty simple. So what this meant, he needed to crash the plane, he needed to go back and get the GoPros that had the footage he needed to make the viral video, and he needed to hide the evidence that showed that there was no mechanical problem with the airplane, and then he crashed it on purpose. Again, remember, this is my opinion, those facts, this is pure conjecture. So I mentioned the fire extinguisher tank could have contained any kind of liquid. Let's start with the most obvious option, and that is the fire extinguishers have fire retardant in them. They're unmodified. So what was his plan? What did he need these fire extinguishers for? Let's assume his plan is to have the aircraft full of fuel, to crash into the ground, burst into flame, and melt all the evidence that shows that there was nothing wrong with the aircraft that caused the engine to stop. His plan would be to land his parachute as close as possible to the aircraft so that he could rush to it with his fire extinguishers and cool a path to the GoPro so he could extract them before the whole aircraft melted into slag and destroyed the evidence. But two things went wrong. First of all, in his effort to get all kinds of free fall footage to make his viral video, he waits too long to open his parachute, which means he ends up landing too far away from his aircraft and it takes him a long time to get there. The other thing that goes wrong is it doesn't burst into flame. Now, a lot of people in the comments have said, what's the big deal? Nobody got hurt. He just like did this little prank and, you know, whatever. Let's talk about what a heinous crime this is. Do you know how dangerous forest fires are in the West? The fire in 2018, the Camp Fire, killed 85 people and destroyed 18,000 structures. And if all what I just laid out is true, he intentionally tried to start a forest fire to get views. That is a crime beyond comprehension, in my opinion. Oh, and it was a condor sanctuary too. Okay, next option. Let's assume he filled the fire extinguishers with gasoline. What would the plan be in this case? Let's say he was so paranoid that a plane full of gasoline would burst into flame and destroy his valuable GoPros that his plan was to make sure that that didn't happen. So what he did, he took off with only a small amount of gas. Then he circled over the area where he wanted to have the engine failure until he ran out of gas. Then he strapped these canisters full of gasoline to his legs, and his plan was going to be this. He would let the aircraft crash. He would go to the crash site, pull his GoPros off, spray the aircraft with the fuel in his tanks, throw a match on it, and then get dramatic footage of the aircraft bursting into a fireball just as he escapes. This probably isn't likely because, as far as we know, there was no fire. But that is what an investigation of the crash site would show, if there were any attempts to start a fire. Now, in both these plans, fire extinguishers filled with fire retardant or gasoline, the plan was for the aircraft to burn to smoldering slag and get rid of the evidence. But clearly that did not happen. So that is where I speculate that he panicked and had to get rid of the aircraft. So he hires a helicopter and dumps it in this lake here, or takes it to the ocean and dumps it there. Again, these are all just theories. I have no proof. Now, there's people saying that the tank could have been filled with water. First of all, nobody puts drinking water in a pressurized tank. Second of all, what on earth would his possible motive be to hide a tank of water so that we couldn't see it? He did everything else to show how prepared he was. He covered his parachute. Why wouldn't he have shown his water? And when he went back to the aircraft, he specifically said he was looking for water and that the tank had broken open. Why didn't he mention he had it strapped to his leg? It doesn't make any sense. So it's getting harder and harder to pretend that this was an accident. There's just so many things that don't add up. Thanks for watching, Alfeeder Zane.